So what we're doing today is we have gotten a list of vacant houses from our title agent, and we're just driving some neighborhoods to check out those vacant houses. And along the way, we found over 20 vacant houses today just driving these neighborhoods. And so we're really excited about that. Most of those are confirmed vacants. And so what we'll do is we'll take some pictures of the house, write down the address, and we'll take it back to the office and check title, first of all. Secondly, we'll check to see if they're listed for sale, and we'll check to see who owns it, because we want to eliminate all the houses that are owned by banks, and we only want to pursue houses that are owned by individuals. And we'll skip trace those owners and contact them and make them an offer that they can't refuse. All right, so here we are. It's Thursday morning, about 8:30 in the morning. We're out looking for vacant houses, and actually we've done fantastic today. We've been driving around this neighborhood for the last 20 minutes or so, and already found, this is our second one we found today. So let's take a quick look. My first, the first thing that tipped this off was just kind of the condition of the yard, obviously not being maintained or anything. But when I popped open this mailbox right here, one thing that they do is they'll write vacant inside of it to let the mailman know that nobody lives here and not to deliver mail. More telltale signs of a vacant house is you're going to see notices from the utility company, and obviously nobody's walked through that front door for a long time, as you can see. Another big tip off was the neighbor came out and said, "Hey, nobody's lived in that house for 7 months." And I said, "Yes." Looks pretty good. This is exactly what we're looking for. So we'll take the address down and continue the work from the office. So here we go. We got another vacant house that we just found. Drive-in neighborhoods. We actually came into this neighborhood with a list of vacant houses, and the one we were looking at or looking for turned out not to be vacant. The one that we found here, it's just down the street. It's really nice. Nice neighborhood, nice place. This is exactly what we're looking for. Sweet house, easily rented. Definitely be a great short sale. Okay, follow me up. Let's check this out. So we found this vacant house. On the door of this place, we got the notice of trustee sale. It has the names of the current owners. These people still own the house, and it shows that this house is going to be foreclosed on in just a couple of weeks. And so what happens a lot of times is people that know that they're going to be facing foreclosure, they just split, they give up, and they leave. And so what I'm going to do is contact these folks and tell them that there's still hope, that I can save them from foreclosure, probably help them restore their credit a little bit, and still get them a ton of debt relief. And that's what we do with vacant houses. So this is actually a really good find. We've got 2 or 3 weeks before the auction date, and so we're going to make it happen in between.
Haha, jackpot. Sometimes the Christmas lights in September will give it away as being vacant. And what do you know, right on the door, there's a notice that the house is in fact vacant. Great little neighborhood, and we're on the hunt today.
So we found another one. One of the things that we spotted here is there's no blinds on the windows, and there's notices from the utility company hanging from the door. So that's a clear telltale sign that the house is vacant. Take a look at this big house. The other thing that I want to show you, if you're not sure if the house is vacant, you can always tell by the electric meter. This one happens to say it's off. That means there's no power turned on this house. A clear telltale sign that it's vacant.